Light carries energy. You can calculate the amount of energy a single photon carries using this equation. The energy of a photon is Planck's constant multiplied with its frequency. So let's test it. How much energy does a blue photon have? Well, a blue photon's frequency is 64 times 10 to the 13th Hertz. So multiplied with Planck's constant, we get 4.24 times 10 to the minus 20 joule. But since mass is energy over c squared, then this blue photon's mass is 4.71 times 10 to the minus 37 kilograms, right? Well, no. Photons do not have any mass. The reason why is because they move at the speed of light, c. And it's impossible for an object which has that property to have any mass. Getting back to the E equals mc squared part, E equals mc squared is true only for stationary objects. And since photons cannot be stationary from any frame of reference, the full equation that all particles satisfy, including photons, regardless their velocity, is energy is the square root of mass squared times the speed of light to the fourth plus momentum squared times the speed of light squared. As you can see, if the object we are talking about does not move, then the momentum part is zero, so the equation becomes E equals mc squared. But in the case of photons, it's the mass part of the equation which is zero, so the final result is energy is equal to momentum times the speed of light, which is equal to hf mentioned in the beginning of the video. But wait, since photons are massless, how can the product of momentum times the speed of light not be always zero, since by definition momentum is mass times velocity? Well, momentum is mass times velocity in classical physics. In special relativity, momentum is mass times velocity divided by the square root of 1 minus velocity squared times the speed of light squared. And if you use 0 for mass and c for velocity, which is the case for photons, results in momentum being 0 over 0, which in math such a term is indeterminate. Not 0, not 1, and not infinity. Simply indeterminate. Which means this equation, and as a consequence, this equation is true but not useful for photons. It is only used to derive the momentum equation for photons, which is hf over the speed of light, and nothing else. So, in conclusion, we use this equation to calculate a photon's energy, this equation to calculate its momentum. We know for a fact that its velocity is always c, and we know for a fact that its mass is actually zero.